Time, it's my pleasure to yield 3 minutes to the gentleman from Nebraska, Mr. Terry, for the purpose of engaging in a colloquy with the gentleman from Utah, Mr. Chaffetz, and myself.
The gentleman from Nebraska is recognized for 3 minutes.
Thank you, Madam Chair, and I rise for the purpose of entering into a colloquy from my friend from Utah joining with me. Now, Chairman Goodlatte, I want to thank you for your attention to the very serious problem of patent assertions entities, otherwise known as patent trolls, here today. On November 14th, the House Energy and Commerce Committee held a hearing entitled, quote, "The Impact of Patent Assertion Entities on Innovation and the Economy." We heard from a variety of witnesses and industry, including the food, hospitality, tech, all of whom had been targeted by vague, unfair, and deceptive patent troll demand letters. That hearing revealed significant economic harm to Main Street businesses in the economy, such patent troll demand letters. These entities engage in abusive practices that often target small businesses because they don't have the resources to fight back. At the markup for the Innovation Act, Mr. Chaffetz offered an amendment that resulted in a sense of Congress in the bill before us today. That language says, and I quote, "It's an abuse of the patent system and against public policy for a party to send out a purposely evasive demand letters to end users alleging patent infringement," end quote. As chairman of the House Energy and Commerce Committee, Subcommittee on Commerce, Manufacturing, Trade, with jurisdiction over these type of consumer abuses, I join with your sentiments. We understand that time is of the essence. I want to yield to Mr. Chaffetz at this point.
I thank the chairman, Chairman Terry, for his good leadership and work on this, and certainly Chairman Goodlatte for bringing this bill. And knowing that you, Mr. Terry, are working on a bill that I'm going to wholeheartedly support. We received support for this approach from many business groups, including the National Retail Federation, National Restaurant Association, the App Developers Alliance, the Direct Marketing Association, the American Association of Advertising Agencies, the Association of National Advertisers, the Food Marketing Institute, the Mobile Marketing Association, the National Association of Convenience Stores, the National Grocers Association, the American Hotel and Lodging Association, just to name a few. These represent hundreds of thousands of businesses and millions of employees across the country. It would be my hope that the House would expeditiously take up any demand letter legislation reported out of the House Energy and Commerce Committee under your leadership. I support it and I yield back.
And the Energy and Commerce Subcommittee intends to proceed through regular order as soon as it is practical to examine both the problem and demand letters and potential solutions to the Federal Trade Commission could implement. We took another step just recently in a hearing with our FTC commissioners this week on the patent trolls demand letter issues. And at this time, I yield back to the gentleman from Virginia.
Madam Chairman, I yield myself 30 seconds so that I can respond and thank the gentleman from Nebraska and the Energy and Commerce Committee for their good work on this issue. He has my commitment to work on this important issue, and we must continue to work to rein in the abuses of these demand letters. I also look forward to working with Mr. Chaffetz and Chairman Upton of the Energy and Commerce Committee, and I know that we can produce a good product to further address this issue within that committee's jurisdiction.
Thank you.
Gentlemen from